Hey everybody, thanks for joining us for our Sunday session. Let's go ahead and have you close your eyes and just reflect on your week. The good, the bad, the neutral. Just reflect. Just observe. That's all you're doing. Silently say, I'm surrounded by the white light of the Christ, of the Buddha, of Brahma, of Kuan Yin, of Master Kutumi. Only good shall come to me. Only good shall go from me. I am surrounded by the white light of the Lord Christ, of the Lord Buddha, of Lord Rama, of Kuan Yin, of Mother Mary, of Master Kutumi, only good shall come to me, only good shall go from me. I am surrounded by the white light of the Christ, of the Buddha, of Rama, of Kuan Yin, of Mother Mary, of all the aspects of Tara. Especially green Tara and white Tara. Of Master Kutumi. Great architect of the universe, may I be a channel through which the Holy Ones approach the world. May I be a center of radiation of thy power. Teach me to travel light, that I may better gain the heights and break the bonds that bind. Teach me to give myself entirely to thy service, to attune myself to thy will. Teach me to lay down the small personal life for the greater cosmic life, and to love with the love of God. If you have a prayer, hold it in your heart. Move your awareness to the top of your head. Now gently project upward as high as you can. Project as high as you can and let it linger as long as you can. Just project upwards. Just be still. Okay. How do you feel? So today, I thought we'd talk about anger. You know, it's one thing to always be talking about spiritual subjects, but sometimes we have to talk about the nitty-gritty issues of everyday life. And one of these is anger. You know, sometimes we have anger and we know why, and sometimes we have anger and we have no idea. It just got triggered, it came up, and you're upset, and if you had to explain it, you couldn't do it for the life of you. Right? And so let's look at some of the mechanisms of what would cause anger. Right? So there is the known sources. You know, somebody does something, they do behavior or betrayal or something, boom, the anger is obvious and easily explained. But then there's a lot of times where we get triggered, we get upset, we get agitated, we get hostile, we get angry, and we try to come up with reasons, but we really don't have a good solid reason. You know, something got triggered, something got stirred, so to speak. And so what is this? Like, what is this type of anger? You know, when we look at it, we really have to look at some of the mechanics, and you're really breaking down types of emotion. You know, you could say that there's higher emotion and lower emotion. You could actually even break it down even further. But for right now, we'll stay with higher emotion and lower emotion. Higher emotion is tied to your psyche. It's tied to your upper faculties. It's tied to how you think. And when you think something, it produces a feeling. And when you feel something, it produces a thought, right? And so when your mental body is going through and processing information, and this happened and that happened, and this person did this and that person did that, that can be one source of anger, but it's not the kind of anger that gets triggered that is kind of like primal or primordial, right? And then we have the lower emotions. And lower emotions are tied more to your physiology. Your physiology generates emotions just like your mental body generates emotions. It helps you to thrive in the environment. Your body generates emotions to help motivate you to take action to protect yourself or to thrive in the environment. You know, the example that I use that, you know, has been very long-winded at this point is you touch a hot stove, right? Your body doesn't pull the hand away because you're aware that there's tissue breaking down and that you're being injured. Your body pulls the hand away because there's an emotional response of, ow, that hurts, and you pull your hand away very quickly. So this is actually a type of physiological emotion, right? It's trying to prevent you from being harmed. Now, if you really break down what is anger, a lot of times it, if you really, really boil it down into the physiology, it is a time when you feel that you're being harmed. It is a time where you feel even deeper that you are vulnerable. Right? And in the old Kabbalistic writings, they bring up this point of sometimes it's when we perceive something happening and we perceive that the wicked are prospering. You know, somebody's causing harm and they're basically getting away with it. Or even further, somebody's causing harm and they're benefiting from it. So this triggers a very primal anger response. It's primal. It's not coming from your mental body. So that's why it's very hard for you to explain it. And eventually this turns into forms of like resentment. It can turn into thought processes that has to do with, I want the person to know how they've harmed me, or they've harmed me and I want to harm them back, right? We don't really think this consciously. It is more your body trying to protect itself. So if you'd say, I really don't have those thoughts. Your mind doesn't have the thoughts, but everybody's body does. And that's why, you know, in spiritual practices, there's so much emphasis on the cultivation of loving kindness. Is loving kindness starts to temper that reaction and starts to turn it into perception of compassion. And it's something that we have to train ourselves to do. It's not something that comes naturally. And so with this, what do we do when we are faced with these situations where, I'm just angry all the time, or I get around this person and I'm angry, or I get around certain behaviors and I get triggered. You know, for me, if you know, we are going to use an example, we might as well use a real one. For me, it's give me a bully, and you can see me get triggered. You know, all these years, I still have to like contain myself, right? And it doesn't have to be a bully directed at me. It could be just a bully picking on somebody weak, a bully picking on, you know, whoever, somebody I don't even know, somebody across the way. You know, one time I got triggered and, you know, I didn't get hostile about it, but I did go and have a little talk with the person. But it was somebody who was bullying somebody at the airport. And, you know, I just felt the need to go and say something. I was very polite about it, but I'm a big guy, so I don't have to say a lot of words. So it's a little bit different from me sometimes. But the idea is that there is some sort of injustice happening. There is some sort of, like we said, the wicked are prospering. And so there's one level where we have to kind of make our peace with the situation so that we don't become so reactive. But at the same time, we have to make sure that our perceptions are clear and accurate so that it's just not that we're not getting our way. And there's also the part where there's times where it's important for us not to turn the blind eye, because there might be something really harmful going on and a person might not be able to say something, but maybe we can, or as a group we can. And so the more that we sit with this idea of anger, it really can be illuminating and quite liberating. But sometimes when we sit with it, sometimes when we look at it, or sometimes we're just so entrenched in it, it's really hard to break away from it. And so there is an old Kabbalistic practice that helps to transmute anger, to transmute resentment, to transmute that idea of being triggered. And so with that, I would like us to do this practice, but as you leave here today, reflect on times where you've gotten angry, and you can sit and hold them in the heart and then do this practice, or just do this practice, and it makes it easier and easier to disentangle and step away from the situation when it's happening. So close your eyes. If you already know of a situation, hold it in your heart. If not, just put your attention and awareness on your heart. Begin inhaling. Silently affirm, I am surrounded by the white light of all the higher beings. Only good shall come to me. Only good shall go for me. Put your awareness on the soles of your feet. Move your awareness to the low back area, opposite your navel, on your low back. Take long, slow, deep breaths. Keep your awareness on the low back area. Move your awareness to the back heart, which is located between your shoulder blades. Move your awareness to the top of your head, the crown. Just be still, be aware, just let go. Again, put your awareness on your heart. Just keep your eyes closed. Put your awareness on the soles of your feet. If emotions or feelings or visions come up, just observe. Move your awareness to the low back, opposite your navel, on your backside. Move your awareness to the back heart, the area between your shoulder blades. Move your awareness to the top of your head. Just let go. Let go of everything. Just let go. in times of difficulties like this, when you get triggered, it is always good to invoke the Archangel Raphael. Raphael is the healer and is associated with healing these aspects. So I will just simply tone the name of Raphael. Raphael. We humbly invoke the blessings and the help of Archangel Raphael. Thank you for helping to heal these triggers and these lower emotions. Thank you for transmuting these lower emotions and help giving us guidance into walking a more peaceful life. Thank you for helping to increase our ability to perceive and improving our perceptions. Thank you for helping us to know peace. We thank you. We thank you for joining us today. I hope you found that a little bit helpful. You can continue to practice this. Again, you can always access the recording of this on our YouTube channel, Astara 1951. Astara 1951. And from all of us at Astara, thank you for your support. Hope to see you again, and we love you guys. Take care.